Good morning everyone. Today I'm here with my next video on the question and answers of the chapter A Day's Wait by Ernest Miller Hemingway. Let us first read the summary of the chapter. Scats is a 9-year-old boy who is innocent and has his fears and apprehensions about life and death, as any young child has. When he hears that he has a temperature of 102 degrees, he thinks he is going to die because he had heard his classmates say that no one lives with a fever of 44 degrees. He spends the whole day thinking that he will die. He seems disinterested when his father reads out pirate stories. He refuses to let people in because he fears that he might infect others at home. The poor child is not able to convey his fright to anyone until that evening when his father explains to him the difference between the two thermometers. Scat's father is a caring father and loves his son immensely. He is relieved to know that his son had a light epidemic of flu and that there was nothing to worry if the fever did not go above 104 degrees. He reads aloud stories for him to take the boy's thoughts away from his illness, but he notices that his son seems very detached. He makes sure that he gives his son medicines on time. And finally, when the son reveals his fear to him, he explains the difference between Fahrenheit and Celsius thermometers and tells him that he isn't going to die. Let us see the question and answers. Question A, answer these questions. Question 1 is, who is the narrator of the story? Answer, the narrator of the story is the father of Scats. Question 2. When did the narrator first notice that Scats was unwell? The answer is, the narrator first noticed that Scats was unwell when Scats came into the room to shut the windows while everyone else was still in bed. Scats looked ill. He was shivering. His face was white and he walked slowly as though it ached to move. What was the doctor's diagnosis? Why did he give 3 different medicines? According to the doctor's diagnosis, Scats had caught the flu. The doctor gave 3 different medicines because one was to bring down the fever, another was a purgative, and the third was to overcome an acid condition, as the germs of influenza could only exist in an acid condition. Question 4. Why did Scats believe that he was going to die? Pick instances from the story which point out that he believed that something was wrong. Scats believed that he was going to die because at school in France, the boys had told him that one could not live with a body temperature of 44 degrees. And Scats had a fever of 102 degrees. Some instances from the story which point out that Scats believed something was wrong are: A. After the doctor left, Scats' face was white and there was dark areas under his eyes. He lay still in the bed and seemed very detached from what was going on. He was not following what the narrator was reading to him. B. Scats did not want to go to sleep. He kept looking at the foot of his bed very strangely. C. Scats asked his father to leave the room if it was going to bother him. D. His body posture said that he was holding tight on to himself about something. E. Finally, he asked his father when he was going to die. Question 5. Why did father go out hunting while his son was resting in bed? The answer is, Scats asked his father to leave if he was going to get bothered, not understanding what Scats meant and thinking that perhaps he was a little light-headed. The narrator gave Scats the prescribed medicines and went out to hunt for a while. Question 6. When did Scats realize that he was not going to die? Scats realized that he was not going to die when his father explained to him the difference between the two thermometers. He told him that on the thermometer in France, 37 degrees, that is Celsius, was normal, and on the other kind, and on their kind, that is 98 degrees Fahrenheit, was normal. Let us see the questions based on reference to context. The first extract is, but when I came back downstairs, he was dressed, sitting by the fire, looking a very sick and miserable boy of 9 years. When I put my hand on his forehead, I knew he had fever. Question A, who are the two people being referred to in these lines? How are they related? The two people being referred to in these lines are the narrator and Scats. The narrator is Scats' father. What was the boy doing? The boy was sitting by the fire, looking sick and miserable. Question C. What was the boy suffering from? The answer is, the boy was suffering from flu, that is light epidemic of influenza. The second extract is, I read aloud from Howard Pyle's The Book of Pirates, but I could see he was not following what I was reading. Question A, who was reading the book? The narrator was reading the book. The narrator is Scat's father. Question B, why was the boy not following what the narrator was reading? The answer is, the boy was not following what the narrator was reading because he had detached himself, waiting for his impending death. Question C, was the narrator able to make out what was going on in the boy's mind? The answer is no, the narrator was not able to make out what was going on in the boy's mind until Scats expressed his concern. Third extract, I'd rather stay awake. Question A, who wanted to stay awake? Answer is, Scats wanted to stay awake. Question B, why did the speaker not want to go to sleep? The answer is, Scats did not want to go to sleep because he was waiting for his death. Question C, did the narrator notice something strange about the speaker? The answer is, yes, the narrator did notice that Scats was acting strange but thought it was because of the fever. Extract 4 is, about how long will it be before I die? Question A, who said these words to whom? Scats said these words to the narrator. Question B, what was the listener's reply? The answer is, the narrator told Scats that he was not going to die and asked what the matter was with him. Question C, was the speaker actually going to die? The answer is, no, Scats was not going to die. He had misunderstood. The next extract is, poor old Scats. It's like miles and kilometers. You aren't going to die. That's a different thermometer. 37 is normal. On this kind, it is 98. Question A, who said these lines? The narrator said these lines. Why was there a confusion in the boy's mind? The answer is, there was a confusion in the boy's mind because he did not know the difference between the Celsius thermometer and the Fahrenheit thermometer. Question C, was the speaker able to convince the boy that he was not going to die? Yes, the speaker was able to convince the boy that he was not going to die. This was done by explaining the difference between the two thermometers, that is the Celsius thermometer and the Fahrenheit thermometer. Write about the father-son relationship. The father was a caregiver to his son. He tended to his sick 9-year-old son, called the doctor, read to him, and made sure that the medicines were given to him on time. The son held deep love for his father in his heart and understood the love that his father held for him too. This was evident when he asked his father to leave the room lest he got bothered. The father could sense the disturbance that the son was having in his mind and constantly kept checking it on him. On returning from the hunting trip, when he found that Scads was unaware of the difference between Fahrenheit and Celsius thermometer and thus had been waiting to die all day, he felt bad for his son and lovingly explained to him the difference between the two thermometers. This proves that father and son shared a deep bond. Question 2. Scads tells his father that he'd rather stay awake. Why do you think he feels so? The answer is, Scads told his father that he would rather stay awake because perhaps he was scared to fall asleep and wanted to stay alert as long as he could. Question 3. Why doesn't Scads allow anyone into his room later? What does this indicate about his fear? The answer is, Scads didn't allow anyone into his room because he feared that anyone who entered his room would contract the same disease that he contracted. This indicates that he feared that he would soon die. So these were the question and answers, reference to context questions and few extra questions. There is a different video in my channel which explains the whole chapter line by line. It also explains the theme of the chapter. Please go through that too. And if you have still not subscribed my channel, please press the subscribe button and the bell icon for the latest notifications. Do let me know on what other topics you want me to make videos on, and I will definitely do it for you. It's just my pleasure. Do take good care of yourself. Bye-bye.